Hello there, you beautiful people. I am Mr. Riddlesworth, and welcome back to Alan Wake, where Barry is leading us on a journey. And the last episode was just really freaking hard and frustrating. What is this?
Those geezers had quite a production going on.
It's the booze. Alive,
I'm gonna start representing them. Yep, sell this stuff online, maybe get a reality show going, release a new single.
Good luck with that, pal.
Yeah.
Hey, you find us a way out here, okay? I'm gonna take a closer look at this.
Boot that door in. Let's see what's in here for us. Nothing. We have to go. I bet this is the way we had to go anyway.
Be careful, Al!
Yeah, I can hear shadows. But I'm good. I've only got 15 shots left. Oop, is that more shotgun ammo? Yeah! Like a boss, giving me all this ammo. Holy crap, boss. Ah, freaking do it. I was gonna stand there, I ain't moving. You're in my way, boy, not the other way around. Boom. Always.
Good. Keep your eyes open, okay?
Yeah, how come he didn't give him a pistol or something to defend himself with? He just freaking runs off upstairs and leaves him alone. Well done, Al. You bastard. Ooh. I'm sorry if I look a bit shiny. I've still got a bit of a temperature, so I'm sweating just a little bit. It's only a slight tackiness. It's nothing too major. Yeah, I'm not sweaty enough to feed a camel in the desert, so to speak. What the freaking hell is that? Is that another torch? Heavy duty lantern. Turn on the radio,
as you regular
star.
Listeners know, I tend to work through the night, but I'm not the only one. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton are taking a couple of moments off their busy schedule to join
okay,
me here in
do?
The studio.
Turn on the generator.
How busy are you now? Deerfest is
batteries. Surprised you haven't found the manuscript page here, to be honest. Rightio.
I could see the building that had to be the Andersons' home on the other side of the field. It wasn't far now. I wasn't worried about trusting the ramblings of two burned-out geriatric wrecks. They had the goods.
That combine harvester just moved. I'm freaked out right now. Anyway, where is he? Ah. It's gonna come alive and chase us, isn't it? I can see it. Yep, that's why it's giving us all this stuff. Because that son of a bitch is gonna come alive and start chasing our asses down.
You've got to be kidding me.
Yep. Told ya. Where's Barry anyway? Holy shit! Can I take it down? I wonder. Should be able to. Oh shit. Ouch. He hasn't got much left. Oh, neither did I. It ran me over. Ah, piss. No. Come on now. Ooh, what happened to the frame rate? The frame rate just fucked off. Hello? Frame rate, where are you? Come back. Oh, if this game had an SLI profile, it would run so smooth on the two graphics cards. I don't know why it slows down so much, to be honest. I mean, I've got it all overclocked to the nines. And it still don't work right. Now it does, what the fuck? The frame rate just come back. Come on, Al.
Got to be kidding me.
Nope. didn't you dodge it? Stupid F. Get the flare. The flare. Come on, we got this. Freaking hell yeah! Who's the boss, you bitches? Come on, bitches. Who's the boss? I owe you, Shadow freaking boys. You're all mine. Ah! Come on, reload that shit quick. Come on. Jesus Christ, it takes so long to die. That's always Barry. Why has he not come out yet? Barry, where are you? Maybe he's not supposed to come out. Maybe I'm supposed to go it alone. What the fuck? Super Alan, look at that. Moves hay bales with just one little touch. Screw Superman, this is my superhero. Valhalla. Yes. Anyway, guys, how the fuck do I get in then? Hello? Is there a hole in the fence? Chainsaw. I can remember seeing a chainsaw in that barn. Behind the carbine. Combine. Carbine. Fucking... No. What the fuck am I supposed to do, bruh? Haven't got a... Good clue. Oh, look. Are you serious? Why can't I just kick the gate open or climb over it? What the fuck? Man. Games have come a long way since this first come out. And we're going to have fun with Alan Wake's American Nightmare next as well. Which is going to be awesome. I've really enjoyed this game, so I'll...
Al? Is that you out there, buddy?
I had to find a key to get Barry
out. You've got a freaking shotgun.
Hang on. I'll try to find a key to get the door open.
Use your freaking shotgun!
Hey,
hell is up? Oh, it's the dragon.
Come on, this place is all dusty. You know I got my allergies.
Coming. So what's the point in that? Just send him into that room for the key.
Hey, let's go, man.
Don't tell me he's gonna open the gate now.
I think we're gonna have to work together to open this gate, Al. It's pretty heavy.
Freaking hell. Absolute
hey,
balls.
I think that's the farm on the other side of the field. We're almost there. This farm is a crazy place for crazy people.
Yep.
We should feel right at home then.
Yep. I know I do. Come on, hey, there's a chainsaw stuck in the tree. Where the hell did you have to change sides, you
come
awkward
on,
son of a bitch?
Do this thing.
Get the chainsaw. Go on, get it. Get it. Look at the size of it. That's freaking huge. That's like a chainsaw for a bear to use. I'm loving the health. I love Viking stuff.
The lights are out. I guess we better check the fuse box.
I guess that means me. Ooh, Firelex. Thermos. Yep, usual place in the kitchen. Do you even know where the fuse box is? Because I don't. I've never been in this house before because it ain't mine. He's just walking around like a headless chicken.
Downstairs was out, but I was
downstairs.
Sure I could fix that at the fuse box.
Oh my god, downstairs. Yeah. No, this is a toilet. What the hell? Where the freaking hell is downstairs now? Sure, I checked everywhere. No, there's no door in there. Have I got to go upstairs to go downstairs? So I've got to go like through the house to go to the other side. If I have, that just sucks balls.
You know, this place looks kind of lived in. I thought the Andersons were in the booby hatch.
Old gods know the truth.
Come on, Al, let's get the lights on, huh?
I'm freaking looking, bruh. Where the fuck? I just walked past the manuscript page. It's upstairs. It says downstairs though, didn't it? This game is just weird.
Can you hear that, Al? Music?
Of course. We need to find where it's coming from. That's the message the Andersons talking about. That's the whole reason we're here.
It's the record player. Record player on the table.
What's your face?
Go!
Crazy lamp lady from the town.
Cynthia Weaver.
Right. Must be.
There we go. See? Freaking genius.
Okay?
We need to find Cynthia Weaver. We'll stay here for the night and head back to town as soon as it gets light.
Hey, Al. Lots of hours before dawn. Might as well get some rest. And by rest, I mean drunk.
Come on, Barry. This is... Yeah. What the hell?
Listen, Al. I'm sorry about this. No, seriously, because... I know we don't get along, but we're gonna find her, right?
Even though you're a crazy bastard, I'm gonna stick by you, no matter what, ever, Al.
Sure, like a brother.
I'm a writer, goddammit.
Correct.
If I just wanted to, I could write 10 books a year. And they'd be the best books that year.
No, you couldn't.
That's right, I couldn't. But I could, because I'm a writer.
What? What do they put in this stuff? I feel like my brain is coming out of my nose. I'm gonna get the recipe off those coots and be a booze millionaire.
I just miss her, Barry. I just want her here with me.
I know, Al. I know. It's gonna be okay. We're gonna make it okay.
Schnell. What the schnell?
Alice! Alice! Where are you?
What's going on here?
Alice, I'm coming. It's all right. I'm coming.
It was a crazy drunken dream, and yet it was more than that. It was the truth. A suppressed memory unearthed by the Andersons' moonshine. I was there, an out-of-body observer. This was the night Alice and I had arrived at Bright Falls, the night Alice had disappeared. I had a chance to find out what had happened. I remembered being surprised to see the cabin dark. Alice would have never turned
Alice?
The lights off.
Alice!
Oh, this is cool.
I remembered thinking, I caught a glimpse of her form underwater, sinking into the darkness. Diving after her was the last vague memory I had of that night. After that, the next thing I could remember was waking up behind the wheel of the crash car and finding the first pages of the manuscript.
So what happened then?
I couldn't find her in all that blackness. I must have thought she drowned.
So we're filling in the blank bit now. Could hear her scream then in the back room.
Alice!
Jagger had Alice, and so she had me.
Alice!
I'd been easy prey.
Look at the cabin. Is there someone in the window?
Alice?
Maybe she didn't drown after all. Maybe she's inside.
Alice!
Yes.
The dark presence had touched me. She had dug her nails into my brain and used me. Okay. Made me her puppet.
Upstairs window.
She must be here somewhere. Maybe upstairs in the study.
Alice!
Yes, that's where she is. You can apologize.
Alice!
You'll laugh at the whole thing together and put it Alice? Behind you. She's not here. You were foolish to think so. No, she's dead. She drowned.
Is she a hypnotist?
No, no, no!
It's your fault your wife is dead. You are guilty. All she wanted
she's
was
a freaking
to
hypnotist.
Help you right. You killed her.
No, you killed her.
Oh, hush. There's still hope. Cauldron Lake is a special place. Here, you have the power to change things.
Yes, but this island doesn't exist.
She wanted you to write. I will tell you what to do.
What the hell is that over there? Weird. Weird light.
You can write her back. The story will come true, and all will be well again.
I feel like Rhett from Good Mythical Morning.
Alice,
look how tall I am.
And the manuscript was the ransom for her.
Da-da-da-da. Is that it?
Yes. I'll write. I'll fix it. I'll bring her back.
Whoa. Creepy bitch.
No. I wrote it.
I remembered it all now. In the dark, I'd written for days, a week, almost a complete manuscript of a novel entitled Departure. Jagger had been my editor, whispering in my ear, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. I thought I was saving Alice. Even with the cobweb she put in my head, some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story, to bring a light into the cabin to release me before I could finish, to interrupt the horror story before the ending, where darkness consumed everything and everyone. Zane was weak and far away, but I had written him into the story, and his light had been enough to set me free.
It isn't here now. I'm here because it was written. I brought the light to set you free. You must hurry. We'll know I'm here. It will be back soon. She stole the skin of my armor a long time ago. She looks so old.
I had woken up, confused and groggy, my mind consumed by darkness and fear. All I could do was to escape. The week spent in the cabin had taken its toll. I was barely conscious and fading fast. It had to have cost Zane terribly, thrown him even deeper into whatever dark place he now haunted. But he had managed to weaken the dark presence, kept me safe that night.
That's right, James Joyce. It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Oh, dear. The sheriff just turns up out of nowhere. Well, not the sheriff, the FBI agent, whatever he is. Douchebag. Holy crap. It's nice to see the blank parts filled in. But it's also still left quite a few questions. First one would be, you know, where the hell is she? Who is this Barbara and what is she? Obviously, in the manuscript, she's some kind of dark, evil spirit, monster, something, energy, whatever she is. She's not real. But Zane has already been lost to the darkness once, so I writ him into the story. Well, Alan writ him into the story as the beacon of light to help him out. It's filled in the gaps, but left me just as confused. I know that Zane's in the game now as the light helping me, and I know that Barbara's the evil spirit that we'll probably have to kick her ass at the end. Anyway, it's getting intense. Thank you guys very much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and will join me for the next episode. And as always, much love to every single one of you. And peace out.